And we live, and we on. New York to Atlanta, man. That's how I'm feeling today, man. Live Hip Hop Daily, man. It's DJ Larry Love. We got a special guest in the building. I'm going to let him introduce himself. I don't even want to say his name. Introduce yourself, bro.
It's your boy Los Lawrence 718, repping BX Borough, keeping it thorough, a.k.a. Dougie Fresh Slow. You heard, you heard?
Hey, man. Listen, man. My man got real merch. Got bandanas, we got masks. Listen, this is how you know art is working. My man mentioned the trend of the coronavirus and the quarantine, and we got real masks. Artists, you got to wear, this is better than a t-shirt. You know why? Because you, a t-shirt probably, nigga probably had it off in the garage for 6 months. But we know you just made these masks for the pandemic.
Well, also, so we, Larry, we'll even go even harder. What did it say on the front?
Allergic to failure, man.
And it's a germ on this. We're trying to be allergic to failure. Oh. Corona right now is the failure rate, right?
Ooh, it's deeper than it's the sea. Failure. See? That's a New York nigga for you, though, man. That's a New York nigga for you, man. So what's up, man? How you, what brings you down to Atlanta, man? What brings you to the city, man?
Just working, playing the field out here. So a lot of the homies that I deal with, especially the crew, we operate out in Atlanta. Even though I'm from New York and I'm living in Florida.
Okay.
Where's the major music scene at right now?
Atlanta.
Yeah. So you got to come where the players are at.
Okay.
So every other week, I'm down here maybe about twice a month.
Okay.
Whether it's recording in the studio, doing video treatments, or just kind of organizing and planning, I tend to actually attend, well, before coronavirus actually happened, different functions to make sure I can get my name out and make sure I'm in the know.
And I like that, man. I already know you. First of all, you're a seasoned, like this ain't, you ain't no, I usually do independent artists that this probably maybe only rap for maybe starting 2 years, 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
But I can tell you're a seasoned artist, but you came in. Also, we got, hey, man.
Flash drops.
We got a credit card flash job, man. You know what I'm saying? This is seasoned artist shit right here. What's going on right now, man? So how long, it's two questions, actually. How long you been, I like to ask artists, how long you been doing it and how long you been taking this shit serious?
I've been taking it seriously for a minute. I mean, but the main thing is that I had a minor setback. We had a federal court case I had to overcome.
Okay.
And after getting through that, I wound up having to start all over from zero. So the way I approached that is like, okay, well, boom, this is the second time around. We already know the ropes to skip, the ropes to know.
Yeah.
People already told us this is what's working, this is what's not.
So you would have to sit down, though? You had to sit down. So
it was light work, but I mean, at the end of the day, I say this too, it was kind of good because the climate of music has changed.
Oh, yeah.
So
oh,
me, I come from that era of the rappity rap rap, I'm going to kill you, obliterate you with bars. You don't really have to do that now.
Right.
So I already know how to ride the wave of the beats. Oh. My producer's already crazy. So I ain't going to fake. All I got to do is spit a B, a C-level rhyme, and y'all making it think I'm the God MC. Who? Jehovah.
So,
and I don't even have to really rap.
So is it more watered down or is it more easier?
I would say it's easier, but I'll also enjoy to hear those different artists like the Griseldas, the different people.
They live here. Actually, they live in Atlanta. I heard
they back and forth. Conway.
Conway.
Benny the Butcher. Those people that actually got bars, or even Rhapsody, who signed to Rock Nation.
Okay.
Those people bars. I enjoy to hear them, but I enjoy all types of music, man.
Okay.
You also got to think about it like this. There's different music for different things.
There is.
I might want to something I might want to throw on to study.
True.
Something throw on to clean the house. If I'm in the gym, I might pop on some D-Block, some Log, something that's crunk, high energy.
Speaking
you know
of D-Block,
saying?
How you feel about the Fab versus Jada versus the
man,
other name?
I think,
Jada.
So check this out. I think I had Fab to win it. Keep it official, I had Fab to win it. That's what my initial thought was.
Okay.
But the way he sequenced, he didn't have his game plan right, and Jada Kiss went in.
It's like a boxing match.
In addition to that, what happened was I have forgot that Jadakiss had them hardcore classics in the paint.
Oh, my God.
And then he had the cheat code is that he was the ghostwriter for so many other people. So now you listening, you like, oh, wait. And then you hear Fab, you know, you thinking, I'm a movement by myself.
Yeah, right.
You can't go against everywhere we go. People, you know what I'm saying? That's like bringing a Derringer and I got a Mac 10. Like, I'm lighting you up with a block. Like, what? Who?
I said the same thing. When I heard that D block,
yeah.
I'm like, oh, yeah, the chant. I forgot all about the song. Is it some songs when you hear it?
Right.
And like, yeah, I don't even know why Fab did. But I understand why they did it. But Jada said, I was watching some interviews prior to that interview, and he was like, it's how you craft the songs together, really.
Right.
You know what I mean? And but that was big for New York. I think that was big. You know what I'm saying? I like talking to New York artists because before it came to Atlanta, it was there first.
Yeah, that's
like
true.
Like, it's here now, of course. Mm-hmm. But just maybe 7 to 10 years ago, it was in New York first. You know what I mean?
Yeah, give or take. Yeah.
I mean, or was it in, I mean, did Cali ever get a run like, I don't know, but Atlanta and New York, just it's the mass media when it comes to music. You know
right.
what I mean? Now,
mm-hmm.
So you coming from the old shit to the out the trunk days to now the digital days, what's better for you? What you think is better, not what's better for you?
Here is this. I like the digital age because the music can get to a person with just a snap of the finger,
true.
Whereas I don't have to hawk you down, hey, my man, You got 5 or 10. Oh, boom, boom. Let me play it out the speaker. What you think? All right, boom. Check it out on my phone. Boom, boom, boom,
but those are the days you come from.
Right. You know, but the digital media is easier for me to transfer from one person to the next person to keeping it spreading.
True.
You don't have to worry about burning a CD or this CD cracks or this, or you lost it, scratched up. You got the digital media saved to your cloud.
You signed to somebody, bro?
No, I signed to myself, Allergic to Failure. That's actually a company, you know, LLC.
I'm just making sure ain't no record label backing this shit up.
Nah. And you know what's so crazy? I have people come to you, they be like, yeah, man, you got too much stuff going together. It's called save your money. That's the first thing.
Yeah, and I can tell you're a student of the game, though. You know, a lot of artists that we meet, they just have the money. They have the back end. You know? And there's nothing wrong with that, because that's what it's about, having a budget. But what got you to that point of wanting to come and pay for and get you to that point? Like, what, you know what I'm saying? And I think a lot of artists lose it, but they don't have something else, the momentum.
Well, I would say also studying the predecessors, but you also have to think, I'm a 2-time graduate from Florida A&M University, School of Business.
Okay, fam. So, shout out to FAMU, man.
Yep, yep. Yeah, Rattlers. Prepare for the new season if all goes well.
Okay.
if all goes well, according to athletics.
Shout out to Rattlers, man. I DJed. It was a club y'all had that had these big-ass temple top, like these poles in it. And I did a party with Webby. I was on the road with Webby.
And that's why I was telling Benny. I say, Larry, look. Yeah, you sound familiar. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? He sound familiar.
We was coming through Tallahassee a lot, man. Total Chaos. I remember Total Chaos.
Total Chaos, yep. In fact, he got a couple records. Total Chaos is going to be the new project coming up.
Seriously?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, rest in peace, man. That's hard.
Mm-hmm.
That's hard, bro. So you've been around, man. Yeah, I like that, man. So you definitely brought a video. You brought some shit that you know, out the stash that you need to drop off that I heard you shot when you was in Atlanta last time, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So what's the name of this song that you brought through?
This one right here is called Zodiac Aries, if you're talking about the one we're going to play.
Yeah, yeah. You about to introduce this shit.
Oh, yeah. So might as well do it now. This joint right here is called Zodiac Aries. We shot it actually in Aries season, which is March, April. Mm. Actually, not too far from this location here. It's got that smooth vibe out, you know, summertime, spring feel for the people out there. You know, mix a little bit of bars, the old with the new. Okay. I think I'd rather let the people determine based upon what they hear.
All right, JB, drop that shit, man.
Yo.
I just want you to love me. Want you to love me.
Real, man.
I just want you to love me. I just want you to love me. Yo, ain't trying to bust a bus, but I'm about to run a conglomerate. Zodiac, Aries, birthstone, diamond, I'm dominant. Graduated fam, I ain't drop out like common sense. No diss to common sense, but had to state it, reason being, y'all be lacking common sense. My state of a Kendrick, eliminate everybody I'm rhyming with. Money we out to get, synonymous like stop and quit. But with success, cause success is what we out to get. I just want you to love me. Well, yes. I just want you to love me.
You.
I just want you to love me.
Hey, man, that's that grutty New York, like, basement flow. Shit, I love it. That's why you said Griselda first. That was and not to compare, but that's to put it in the same on the same street. Mm-hmm. I like it. It's bars, but I could tell you dumbed it down as well, you know what I'm saying,
yep.
Just to match the trend, whatever, you know what I mean? I like that, bro. You know what I'm saying? We got to hear more of that shit. What's the name of the album, the EP? You got something you got to be pushing more than that.
Right now, we got a tape called Allergic to Failure. So you can find it on all digital platforms, whether you're Spotify, anything you want to get on. You can Google it. It'll all come up. Black and white cover, Allergic to Failure.
Yeah.
And it's part of a trilogy that we're doing.
Right.
So the first one is called Allergic to Failure, but the one that's going to get ready to come up in 2021, that's called Addicted to Success.
So we're going from allergic to addicted.
Right. Like and then after that, the third one to conclude the trilogy will be called Only Believers Achieve Success. So Allergic to Failure.
Okay.
Addicted to Success.
Okay.
Only Achievers Believe Success.
So, bro, you ain't really, all you really need is people to see what's going on, what y'all got going on. It ain't like that's all you need. You just need people to see what the fuck y'all got going on. That's it. Everything else is ready.
I believe so.
Yeah, so you coming to Atlanta, you know, I think it's perfect, you know. You know, it's Southern hospitality down there. Like, you a real up north, so you may have to rub shows with a nigga. You may have to do a feature with a nigga, but that's all it may take. Mm-hmm. And the next thing you know, everybody coming back to your shit. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a melting pot. You know how big New York is in Atlanta? It's
yeah.
big.
Yeah, you know, people from all over.
They need that side. They need that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just recommending, like, you know, the ball shouldn't stop. That shit hard. You know what I'm saying? That shit was only a minute long, but it's hard. You know what I mean?
I can't wait for you to critique the whole project when you get a free moment, you know, yeah, after you finish the hamburgers and cheeseburgers, yeah, you know, hit the ribs and, the, and you know, the Remy, you know, the Deuce. Then you come back to it and be like, yo, I got you to listen to that project and give me your full honest opinion. Yeah, because I always ask for honest opinion because you can say, it was straight. When I hear straight, I'll be like, bro, that's a six or seven. If you be like, it was hot or it was just popping,
I'm
going to
tell you what
lit,
songs I like. That's how you know a nigga
even better. Because sometimes you run up on a person, you will hand them something. And that's why I believe in if a person pays for it, 9 out of 10, they're going to listen to it faster than if you give it to them.
Yeah.
So true. You run down on somebody and be like, yo, did you listen to that tape? Yeah, man, I listened to it. Oh, yeah, what's track number two called?
Yeah. That's how you try it. If they really fuck
right.
with
you. You know what I'm saying? Really what's the vibe? Oh, well. And it got so bad, I used to clown Benny. I said, that's the fastest way I could always tell. When the person needs a favor from me, I'd be like, yo, did you watch my video? Nah, I didn't get a chance to do it. Did you get a chance to listen to that album I passed you? Nah, I didn't get a chance to do it. Yeah. Well, remember this favor you want me to do? I'm not going to have a chance to do it.
And it's and you know what's crazy is? We was just talking to, I interviewed a younger girl, shout out to Asian Nate earlier this week, man. We interviewed her. And I was talking to her, and she was saying that, she was younger, so, coming out, having that back door love, that backyard love is important, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And it's hard to get sometimes, but it's like the people next to you sometimes will support you after they see other motherfuckers. And that's fucked up, though.
It's
like the people right next to you, they will support you, but once they see a motherfucker of reach support you.
It's extremely foul because you can have your own cousin that you grew up with playing in the sandbox that hate on you, but somebody you never met that met you on social media, they trying to pass you free things, they trying to send you money, they trying to do whatever they can to support you, but the person that you grew up with or that knows you could be your mother sometimes, your father, will not give you that same support that a stranger will. Once again, I got to look at the camera that a stranger will give to you.
That's funny.
It's a lot of friends that been know we was doing music. Yeah. Like, all right. Turn on somebody else's joint, go cop their joint first.
Yeah, yeah.
Then now you see us, oh, you did it. This is 50 interview?
Yeah.
Wait, you won Source Unsigned Hype?
Yeah.
Wait, you was in newspaper?
Yeah.
Wait, you had Molly's World Casting? That was the big thing for we just did the video shoot for Shake It Baby. Molly's there? Oh, she does casting for Rick Ross. Yeah. Oh, so-and-so's there. He shoot the videos for Future. He shot your video?
And people just want to see you around shit. And it's fucked up.
Negroes.
But
sorry.
You know what it is? It's perception.
And you're 100% right, Larry, but it should not be that way.
It shouldn't be.
You should judge me accountable by my words and my actions.
Yeah.
If I say I'm going to do such and such, I'm going to do such and such.
Yeah.
Today is the 4th of July. I say, I'm going to bust a play to Atlanta, even though I was just there.
Yeah.
Go do the video.
Yeah.
Drive my mans back, and I'm going right back.
That's sacrifice.
Right.
Yeah, that's sacrifice. And I tell people, I think coming out of this pandemic, the biggest thing people I've been seeing is manifestation.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So when you talk certain shit into existence, it's only bound to happen if the action meets. You know what I mean?
And plus, the pandemic is a gift and a curse, but for me, I look at it as it's a blessing, which means it slowed a lot of things down. So you're touring, you're going to this, you're going to that. I no longer have to be like, nah, try to make up some type of excuse.
Yeah. Facts. Facts.
Let's go out to dinner and hang out.
Facts.
Nah, baby. Everything closed.
Right. I don't feel safe. Too many people over. It's too many people. I don't even feel safe going there. Like, let's do Uber Eats. So let's just DoorDash it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
but
I feel you.
You think we should fly to Cali to do a studio? So, yo, man, the plane, man. We might catch COVID. You know?
Exactly,
you know
that, man.
That's $2,000 in my pocket. Yeah, I didn't really want to spend it anyway. I was going to piece on this and flip and get my money back and double up.
Amen.
You know, it's a different thing.
Amen. So before you get out of here, though, so what can we look for the fourth quarter? Because I think the fourth quarter starts roughly October. I would say October.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
So it's funny that you make mention of that. So what we're going to do in the next few weeks, we're going to drop a record as well as a video called She Love Me.
Okay.
So that's going to give the people their last little bit of summertime vibe.
Okay. Who the producer?
We got a producer by the name of Nefarious on
there. Okay. Shout out to the producer.
Then we coming back with Shake It Baby, the one that we just shot last week.
Okay.
That's going to drop in September.
Okay.
We're going to let that rock.
Labor Day.
Right.
Okay.
Right, let that ride to maybe November. Then we're going to come back with another video called Forgive Me.
Okay.
Then running into January, we're going to drop a joint called Pretty Girl, which is, I think you're going to like that. The ladies going to like it. You're going to, Remember how we talked about that Fab type of lane? It's like that. I'm giving the ladies that beat, but I'm talking them balls for the fellas.
That's real. And I like the, you know, I like to influence the young niggas, the young OGs, the young kings that's up and coming. Mm-hmm. What can you tell the younger guys, the guys in high school? What can you embrace them with? What type of knowledge before you leave out these stuff?
I would say use your time wisely, because as you get older, you acquire more responsibilities that kind of deviate you from your task, your plans at hand. I would say, when it comes to building your team, you don't need 20 to 30 to 40 people. You need just 5 solid people, and everybody has to know their role. Everybody can't be the rapper. Everybody can't be the video guy. Yeah. Everybody can't be the manager. Y'all find your role and stick to it, maximize and do it well.
Right.
Pool your resources, put your bread together. I know Jordan's and jury is cool, but look, you take your money, you start slow, you keep reinvesting into the pot, because at the end of the day, when you get more money and more accolades, that stuff is going to come to you.
Yeah.
So right now, you're pushing your bread out to the people. Like, yeah, you're fishing. But once you start moving up into the game and building your success, you don't have to use that push strategy. It's going to be pulled. They automatically coming straight to you. It's just laws of attraction.
Tug of war.
Yep.
I like that, man. We dope, man. Live hip-hop, dead man. Real artists, man. Los Lawrence, 718 in the fucking building, man. New York to Atlanta. Yeah. You know, it's DJ Larry Love, J Black behind the camera, man. Drop your Instagram before they get here so they can find you, man.
Oh, everything is Los Lauren, L-O-S, Lauren, L-A-U-R-E-N, 718.
Word.
Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. We even got the Vimeo. Like I said, you can Google me. You'll see it. More than 10 pages worth of material.
Let's do it, man. We allergic to failure, man. We out of here. Live Hip Hop Deli.
Yay. Thanks for having me. Yeah.